I'm checking in to check it out. So, shout out to one of my subscribers. One of the guys that comments quite a lot in my videos, named Sky. Sky.N. I think that's right, innit? Yeah, man. Yeah, you left a comment on one of my videos. I think what I put up the other day about women taking accountability or whatever. Blah blah blah. But anyway, yeah, because at the start of that video, I was talking about how there's this girl, well, a woman in it, who works in an office that basically where I go and get my work from, yeah? Because I'm a subcontractor, so I go in there, and she's one of the people who works in the part of the staff anyway. And you know what? the same shit happened again today, you know, it's like clockwork. Walked in there. Cause she probably sits about 7-8 meters away from the front desk. And you got like two people who work at the front desk, yeah? Who give her jobs or whatever, blah blah blah. And as soon as I walk in now, I just seen like, let's say I'm like facing this way. Her desk would be like that side. And as soon as I walk in now, I can see in my peripheral vision that she's over there checking. She's checking. She keeps looking. She keeps looking. You know what I mean? I just thought, wait. I thought, okay, cool. I'm thinking, right. Any minute now, yeah, she's gonna get up to the fucking, she's gonna go to the fucking, what's it called now? I forgot. She's gonna go up to the printer. She knew I was there, so she's probably thinking to herself, right? Let me see what I need to do to print out this, so I can go up and get a closer look. And as clockwork, that's what she did. I was waiting for her. I thought, wait, I know for a fact you're gonna come up to get a closer look, and that's what she did. She came up to the printer, and like the printer's like right behind the front desk, and she's there. Like I'm talking to the guy at the front desk. Obviously, I'm looking up. I can see her looking at me, so I'm just like I just give her a look. You know, I looked at her. You know, it's just a friendly smile, and like it's just so obvious what she does. But like my man was saying, it's not even worth going there, though. It's not worth going there, bro. You get me? Because especially it could be awkward. Like I said, it could be awkward. Cause I work there quite often. So let's say I get denied. Let's say I get palmed off. You know how women are, bro. Women can have men. Women can have a man, yeah. And she might see a man that she likes, and she'll make it known that she likes him by looking at them. You know what I mean? By staring at them. But if you try and approach it, she'll deny you. So it's like, it's happened before, so you know what I'm saying? So, let's say I did approach it, or somehow I got talking to it. Yeah, talking to her. I could easily get denied, yeah? And then it'll just make it awkward, bro. Like every time we go into the office now, it'd be kind of awkward. Actually, not for me, really, because I don't mind rejection. I can take rejection. You know what I mean? But could be awkward, but like, anyway, my mum was saying that it's not worth getting involved with women at work, which is true, because I've got involved, I've had women at work before, I've fucked women at work with before, think maybe once or twice, and it didn't work out for various reasons. Like, it wasn't a like long lasting thing, but it just didn't work out. And he was just like, he's just always kind of awkward, bro. And there's one in particular, yeah. Cause I used to work at Yodel, so I used to pull their tractors. I used to pull their tractors and trailers, yeah. And there's a girl there named Yasmin, yeah. She's fly girl. So I think she's Turkish, I think. She's fly. Cause originally she started off as security, like in the gatehouse security, yeah. And again, she made it known she was on me. She kept on looking at me, you know what I mean, smiling and that. I thought, cool. And I thought, let me wait till I catch her by herself. Cause sometimes the security will come out by themselves, innit? Yeah, to walk wherever they're going. I just happened to be outside by my truck one day, and I just called her over and we started chatting. I got her number and that. And you know, we started dating, and people, and obviously knew, you know how it goes. The news started flowing that I was dating her, like I was dating her, seeing her, and all that stuff, yeah. And because when she came onto the scene as a security, everyone was on it, bro. Like she was like the talk of the, she was the talk of the company. Like drivers fancied her, the people in the office, the transport team, they fancied her, yeah. But obviously none of them had a chance to get me, really, to be honest. And that's not me being big-headed, but they didn't have a chance. You know what I mean? Because the state of the people there, anyway. But anyway, I managed to get the number and that. Managed to bang it, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And, yeah, once they found out I was with her, bro. Because before that, I had such a good relationship with the people at Yodel. I had a real good relationship with the people who worked there, like the management, all the staff there. I had a, you know, everything was cool. I was like one of their favorite drivers, bro. You know what I mean? So, and I don't know, the vibe just kind of changed a little bit, man. You know what I mean? When I found out I was dating Yasmin, I was like, she's gone. You know what I mean? Yeah, so it made things pretty fucking awkward, yeah. It didn't work out, it didn't last long. I can't remember the reasons why it didn't last long though, but she's not there security no more. She's actually a driver now. She drives trucks. Because you got a load of beta males there, yeah. You'll just do anything for her, you know what I mean? Like, giving her favors. Like, she had no truck license before. But since she was working there and people like her, they put her through a fucking test. And now she's driving the Arctic, like I drive now. Get me? And that's the power of pussy. That's the power of pussy. If you look good and you're in a workplace dominated with males, men will go to what's the saying? They'll just go to Earth and beyond. Yeah. Try and get peace, you know what I mean? Or try and get in their good books, whatever. Hoping that one day, you know, they might get a chance. They ain't getting no chance. But yeah. So yeah, man. And one time, I think that's part of the reason why I got let go from there, because there's an incident there, right? Actually, there wasn't an incident, because I had a YouTube channel then, because a couple of people knew about my YouTube channel who I worked there with, and obviously when I found out I was dating that Yasmin, yeah, and the stuff I was talking about on there, like steroids and stuff like that, I bet I couldn't wait to say, oh, hey, Look at the stuff what Chezzy's saying on his YouTube channel. And basically that's what I got let go from. I got let go from that company because of my YouTube channel, basically because I was talking about steroids and what I've took before. So they were just looking for any reason to get me the fuck out of there. Yeah? They were looking for any reason to get me the fuck out of there once I found out I was dating the golden girl. Because she was, trust me, she was the golden girl of that fucking company. I don't know if she still works there or not. I don't know. I haven't seen her for about, you know, I was dating her back in like 2014. I think I seen her a few years ago. I think she's still chucking a few years ago. I think she's still doing it now, I don't know. But yeah, they were looking for any reason to fucking get rid of me, yeah, from there. And like, get rid of me because I was talking about steroids, okay. I literally got called into the office, yeah, by the agency, and said, look, you know, someone told me about your videos. I can't tell you who, but you know, the stuff he was talking about in there, we can't, you know, we can't condone it, and we can't, you know, work, you can't work in from now on. I was like, all right, okay. Obviously, I'm agency. I've got a leg to stand on, and I'm talking about Class C drugs. So that was their means of getting me out by any means. So that's what I'm trying to say. You get hate. You get a lot of hate. Especially, you know, interracial as well. I'm black. I think she's half Turkish, half white, so she's white. Listen. I'll say about half people don't really mind it. Interracial relationships. And I think other people do mind it. But they might not say anything. Or you got people who do say stuff about it. You know what I mean? So behind the scenes, they might have not liked it. If I was white, it might be a different scenario. I reckon if I was white, it'd be a different case scenario at all, completely, trust me. But anyway, yeah, man, I've had some dudes do some, bro, when I used to live in fucking Colchester, yeah? When I was in the army, I was going out with Colchester's finest. That's no word of a lie. I'm not even exaggerating, bro. Everyone wanted a piece of her, bro. I'm just gonna call her Pops. Everyone wanted a piece of Pops. You know, she was exotic looking. I can't remember what color she was exactly, but she had like a real dark color. I can't remember. She definitely had. She had like a mix of different ethnics. I can't remember what it was though. But she was hot. She was about like 5'2", short black hair about there. I might even dig a picture up actually, and put it as a screen as the I'll put up as a screen as the screens not a screensaver, as a thumbnail. But yeah, man, trust me, every man wanted a piece of Pops, bro. Everybody, from the people in the town, from the squaddies you were there with, everyone wanted it, bro. And I did, bro. Obviously a fat, you know. I seen her about and I thought, yeah, she's hot. But her friend was dating one of the guys that I know from the army. And basically she told her friend to tell my friend that she interested in me. I was like, yeah. I was like, fucking hell. Like, yo, I'm fucking winning here, bro. I've got Colchester's finest. Yeah? I've got Colchester's finest. And wow, that was a shock, man. I was like, she was like a few years older than me. I was like about 21. I think she might have been about, I don't think she was that much older. She might have been about 25 at the time, something like that. And like, yeah, man, I was in a bit of a shock, to be honest. You know what I mean? And I'm thinking, I was like, you know, I was younger than, you know what I mean? And I seen, like, I looked at her and I thought, she was popular, everyone knew her. And I thought, you know, I think, fucking hell, you're interested in me. You know what I mean? I thought, fair play, I thought, yeah, man, I'll take that. And like, in a situation like that, where you feel like you've hit the jackpot, like, I wasn't really ready for a girl like that. You know, because she was like one who's always, she used to go out partying all the time and that, you know what I mean? Don't get me wrong, that's what we used to do in the army as well anyway. I didn't always do it though at the start, but you know, I started to do more so. And she was out like a good good 3 nights a week. And you know, she'll text me, say, you coming out tonight? Blah, 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 blah. I'll be like, oh, I don't know, you know, I'm not sure, you know, not too sure. Oh, like, come on, man, don't be boring, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay, yeah, cool. So it's almost like I was like chasing her tail. So like, you know, whatever she wanted to do or whatever, I was like following it, you know what I mean? Because, yeah, I was just following it. I just thought, yo, that's the first time where like a girl kind of wore the trousers. She wore the trousers in that relationship. But not a relationship, I was only seeing it for about 4 or 5 months, and then it just fizzled apart, whatever. But yeah, I got some drama with that, bro. You know how many men tried to fight me for her, bro? Like, literally fight me, bro. They'll see me at the bar, yeah? And like, and some of the guys who was based down there in the Colchester, some of the guys from the parachute regiment, yeah? Because obviously, there's some hot, some of those guys in the parachute regiment, there's some nutters, bro. They're nutters. Like, I rate them. Because, like, they just do anything, bro. Like, they're just, like, next level. I have a man trying to, like, fight me, bro. Like, they see me with her, bro. And they want it, yeah. And they'll try to do some shit, like barge up against me and all that. You know what I mean? Just a sight. Just to cause dramas. You just get it all the time, bro. Man's literally trying to fight me, bro. You know what I mean? Could have that jealous. But yeah, man, I've had my fair share of like hot chicks, bro. But at that time, I was young, innit? So I wasn't really ready for a girl like that, though. I wasn't really ready. So like, I was kind of chasing her coattails. You know what I mean? I wasn't really ready for a girl like that. You know what I mean? So. And like, we was out most nights, man. Like, there's like a bunch of us, we was out most nights. Obviously I could get away with that because I was young, innit? Obviously I couldn't do that now, but yeah, man, I've had my fair share of some hot chicks, bro, and like, and they come with their problems, get me? And what else wanna say? But yeah, man. Okay. I'm a fair chair. And, I was just thinking, man. I was thinking about that video that I've done the other day about, what was it now? Single women with kids. And yeah, that video. And how that more time than not, when I come across women, yeah, who are single and I've got kids, obviously dad ain't around no more for whatever various reasons. Yeah, but more time than not, the dad is either some deadbeat, or yeah, there's some deadbeat motherfucker. Or someone who's emotionally abused them or physically abused them and all that shit. Yeah? Causing pure dysfunction and that, yeah? And, like I was saying before, when these women go for these kind of men, yeah? Whether it's their baby dad or they've split from the baby dad and go with different men and end up with some fucking dusty, crusty leech of a dude or some dude that fucking puts their hands on them and that causes pure dysfunction, yeah? Yeah? It's like it leaves a fucking, it leaves an imprint in their mind. It leaves an imprint in their mind to where, like, when someone like me comes around, yeah, who's going to be serious with them, yeah, I don't give a fuck, yeah, you might have three, four kids, whatever, I can be, but if I'm feeding you, I'm going to be serious with you, yeah? But since I've been with so many, since I've been with these fucked up men, yeah, they don't know how to fucking act, bro. They don't know how to act. Yeah? They can't see what's in front of them, bro. You get me? They can't see what's in front of them, bro. Like, people might think, wow, why would you wanna settle down with a girl who's got like two, three kids or whatever, two, three, four kids? Why do you wanna do that? It's because I like the person. Yeah, the person seems cool for me, seems right for me. That's why. And I'm aware of the situation, I'm aware of the kids and that, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, so it's cool, I've got kids myself. Yeah. But what they don't realize is, yeah, that they can't see what, they can't see that there's a guy like me in front of them who's gonna be serious about them. They don't know how to act, bro, because they're so fucked up from their previous relationships, yeah? They're so fucked up, yeah? They don't know how to fucking act. As I was saying before in my last video, like, just don't know how to act. You can't do the basics, bro. And they'll be floating around, bro. They'll be just floating around, getting used and abused, yeah? And good for them. Because they were thinking back, you know, like I said, yeah, they were thinking back and thinking, you know what? Chess was cool, you know. You know what I mean? Chess was cool. He spent his, you know, he'd use his spare time to come see me and that. We'd go out and do things with the kids and shit like that, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? And I made my intentions clear. Said, look, I'm not here just to like, I'm not here to just, like, just for the sake of being here, I'm here to like be serious. You know what I mean? But I gotta see something from you, though. I gotta see you as a person more. I gotta know who you are. I gotta know who you are as a person before I make that decision. So it might take me a while. Yeah. So if you show me good things, then more likely you're gonna be more inclined to think, yeah, I'll settle with her. But if you're doing weird shit in that, it's gonna make me go the other way. It's gonna make me put a step back a little bit. You know what I'm saying? So these women don't realize, bro. They don't realize, man. But I think there's something else I gotta talk about as well. Yeah, man, but like, when you're dealing with women like in their 30s and that, or late 20s, they're gonna have baggage, bro. Yeah? They're gonna have baggage. And, they're gonna have baggage and past traumas from other relationships. And can't seem to switch it off. You know what I mean? So they'll just go from, they'll bounce from man to man. Good luck with that. You know what I mean? You ain't gonna find a man like me. You ain't gonna find a man like me. And no, I'm, you know, again, I'm the average man in terms of like wage. Like, you know, I earn an okay amount of money every year. You know, I'm cool, I'm laid back. My stroke game is fucking on point. Yeah, my stroke game is on point. I'm half decent looking, and I can be serious with you, as long as you show me the right signs. But these, you know what I mean? You ain't gonna find people like me are few and far between, trust me. few and far between. So that's how we go. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man. But yeah, I think I'll wrap that up now. Oh yeah, one of my other subscribers said that. he said, sleepy number through. When I was talking about that girl at work, he said, sleepy number through and keep it moving. Trust me, I've done that before. Like at other places. I never got a call. And that's where I'm thinking, I'm getting some good choosing signals here. I'm thinking, yeah, she's on it. You know what I mean? I've done it before, it don't always work. But I wouldn't do it anyway, like I said to you. Like a buff black dude, bro. Coming after the hottest girl in the office, bro. They don't want to see that, bro. They don't want to see it. Trust me, they don't want to see it. But yeah. Like, how shit is now, like, dating is fucked up now at the minute, bro. Too many distractions going on. Social media going on. Don't be wrong, I'm saying that, but I've got a social media. Cool, but, you know. But, it's just different now these days, bro. It's just different. You know what I mean? It's different. But yeah, without rambling on too much, but it's nearly a 30 minute video. And with that, I'm out. Let's get a most muscular while I'm here. Let's see.
He's facing, not even facing the right way.
He's soon turn around.